Well, it's midweek and it's been a last minute decision to grab my camera and head to Loch Lomond, hopefully to capture some time-lapse photography of the Northern Lights tonight. It's to be around KP6 from 10pm onwards, so if the sky stays clear, which is predicted, I'm hopeful that we can shoot some time-lapse. We'll see how we get on. It will be pretty busy, I'm sure, with other photographers being out, but that's to be expected, so we'll see how we go. Well, I've just arrived at Lush. Heading down, gonna get a scope about. I'm sure we can find a nice composition and hopefully wait about for a few hours, get the Northern Lights. We'll see how we get on. Myself and Sean were the first two to arrive at Lush that night, so we get set up quickly and took a few test shots. I was actually moving some rocks about, trying to create some foreground interest in my image, or some kind of leading line leading out to the Northern Lights in the horizon. But in the end, ended up scrapping the full idea with the rocks. It was too distracting an image. I was here to take a picture of the Northern Lights, or a short time-lapse video of the Northern Lights, and the rocks were just too distracting, I thought. By this point, there was probably about another 20 photographers who'd arrived. I've overexposed a few images just to show you the shoreline and how busy it was. I put my camera on bulb mode and plugged in my intervalometer. I had that set to take a series of 250 still images, which I would then paste together in post to create a short time lapse. I settled on 20 seconds for each image. I found that 30 seconds or even 25, the stars were looking slightly blurry. That was because they were moving slightly. So 20 seconds was ideal for each image. I had a 1 second gap between each image. I was using my Sony's Ice 16 to 35mm lens, shooting at 16mm the full time, nice and wide, so I could capture as much of the sky as possible. And the Milky Way was also in the frame, so 16mm allowed me to capture that in the image. It's an f4 lens, which is the largest aperture I can get on that lens, so obviously I had it set at f4 to allow as much light into the lens as possible. And I had my ISO set to 1600. At the summit of Ben Ann around 6:30 in the morning, which seems quite early, but it wasn't early enough to actually capture the sunrise. The sun was already above the horizon when we got there, which was slightly disappointing, but we still got the cameras out, got a nice few images, and we got the drone out and flew that about as well. There wasn't any wind, so it was perfect for flying the drone about. It's a great short hill to climb. It's only 454 metres, which is not really that high, but it is a great vantage point from the top. The views in all directions are stunning. You get great views over Loch Katrine. We still managed to capture some nice images on the summit, but the highlight for me was the aerial footage that we got. We messed around flying the drone back and forth, setting up different shots. So I'll leave you with a few images and the aerial footage of Ben Ann and Loch Katrine. Thanks for watching.